Here in this case, this is for one complete cycle, whatever the time, it is called period of time. For half cycle, it is called, what to say, that is T by 2. For quarter cycle, it is called T by 4. Now, this is called, what to say, 3T by 4. Now, this is called, what to say, T. Now, up to this, right, T by 4. Now, here, T by 2. Here, 3T by 4. Here, that is T. Right, after T by 4 seconds, there is a maximum current I naught. Right, after 3T by 4 time, the current is, what to say, minus I naught. Now, if I is represented by the current, thereby instantaneous current is given by I is equals to I naught sine omega t plus pi. Right? Now, I is the instantaneous current where? Right? I naught is equals to peak current or what to say, maximum current. Right now, here omega t plus phi, right, omega t plus phi is called total phase of the current. Omega t plus phi is total phase of the current. Now, total phase, omega is equals to angular velocity. Or let us consider angular frequency. This is also known as, what to say, angular frequency. Both are angular frequency. Right now, omega is equals to, what to say, 2 pi nu. R is equals to, what to say, 2 pi by t. Now, here, I want to define what is t. I want to define what is nu. Right, what is t? The period of time. The time required for one complete full cycle of AC current is called period of time. Or, what is the frequency? The number of cycles per second. Number of AC cycles per second is called frequency. Now, omega is equals to angular velocity or angular frequency. Angular frequency is 2 pi nu and what to say, 2 pi by t. Now, this is called AC current. Current is there must be a EMF is there. Now, EMF is equals to, again, is equals to E naught sine omega t plus pi. Omega t plus pi. Instantaneous EMF, maximum EMF, sine omega t plus pi. Here is also sine omega t plus pi. This is the expression for current and this is the expression for EMF. Thereby, that is EMF. Therefore, I versus t is the graph like this and E versus t is also graph like this. Whenever the AC current is in the form of sinusoidal, to explain the behavior of AC currents, we want to define some other characteristics of current. Some other characteristics means, first one, instantaneous current. That is represented by I. Second one, average current. This is represented by I of average. Now third one, what to say, RMS current. Therefore, what to say, I of average, next I of RMS current. Now, whenever the AC current is there, in order to understand very well, therefore you want to define some other characteristics. And fourth one, what to say, fourth one is peak current. Peak current. Or what to say, maximum current. Maximum current. Right, maximum. It is represented by what to say, I naught. What is the instantaneous current? Now already I said, instantaneous current I is equals to I naught sine omega t plus pi. This I represents instantaneous current. Now here, what is the average current? Average current in half cycle, average current in full cycle. What is the right average current in the half cycle? I of average is equals to 2 I naught by pi. I of average current is equals to 2 I naught by pi. 2 I naught by pi. In the full cycle, that is I of average is equals to 0. Now, therefore, in the case of alternating current, right, average current can be defined in half cycle, average current in the full cycle. Average current in the half cycle is 2 I naught by pi. That in the full cycle, average current is equals to 0. Next, here. Right, what is I naught? I naught is the maximum current. This is called, what to say, I naught. This is the value of I naught. Therefore, here I naught is equals to peak current or maximum current. Next one. What is the RMS current? Now, RMS current, how to define RMS current? Right. After an interval of time t1, what is the instantaneous current? I1. After an interval of time, other time, what is the instantaneous current? I2. Therefore, here, after next interval of the time, right, instantaneous current is I3. And so on. Therefore, IN is the current. Now I1, I2, I3 and so on, IN are the instantaneous current. I1, I2, I3, I4 and so on, IN are instantaneous currents. Now I am doing the square. I1 square, I1 square, I1 square, right? Next. Therefore, what to say? Square of the instantaneous current. I1 square plus I2 square, I1 square, I2 square, I3 square, and so on, IN square. These are called squares of instantaneous currents. These squares of instantaneous current, right, what to say? This is called, what to say, right? Sum of squares of instantaneous currents. I1 square plus I2 square plus I3 square, and so on, IN square. This is called squares of, sum of squares of instantaneous currents. Now, here in this case, divided by N. Right? What to say? Whenever you are divided with the N, average, mean. Therefore, this is called mean squares of the currents. I1 square plus I2 square plus I3 square and so on. IN square divided by N is called mean square current. Now here this is the root. This is the root. Now root mean square current. Therefore this is called, what to say, I of RMS. Therefore I R of RMS is equals to square root of I1 square plus I2 square plus I3 square plus so on IN square by N under root. Therefore I of RMS. This I of RMS may be calculated as I naught by root 2. I naught by root 2. Right? What is the importance of RMS current? There are voltmeters are there, ammeters are there, right? Here to measure DC current, DC voltage, DC ammeter. To measure AC currents, AC voltmeter, AC ammeter. Generally, by using the AC ammeter, there is a current. By using the AC voltmeter, there is a voltmeter. Therefore, it will give you RMS value. It will give you RMS value. Therefore, now AC voltmeter AC ammeter will give you RMS values. Suppose AC ammeter gives RMS value of the current. AC voltmeter gives RMS values of the voltage. I told you in the terms of only currents. Now, in the terms of here, instantaneous current is represented by I is equals to I naught sin omega t plus pi. And instantaneous EMF, AC EMF is represented by E is equals to E naught sin omega t plus pi. What is E? Instantaneous EMF. What is E naught? Maximum EMF or peak EMF, sin omega t plus pi. Now sin omega t plus pi is called phase, omega is called angular velocity, and remaining terms have the same meaning. Now instantaneous current, right, this is called instantaneous voltage. Next one, average EMF. Similarly, average EMF, average current, average EMF. Therefore, in the half cycle, that is average EMF, average EMF is equals to 2E naught by what to say pi. In the full cycle, that is average EMF is equals to 0. Similarly, there is a RMS current is there. RMS current is there means RMS voltage is also there. Therefore, now V of RMS. R E of RMS, no problem. V of RMS R E of RMS is equals to E naught by root 2. Therefore, I RMS is equals to I naught by root 2. E RMS is equals to E naught by root 2. Right? Average current. Right? Average current in half cycle 2 I naught by pi. Average EMF in the half cycle 2 E naught by pi. In full cycle, average current is equals to 0, and in full cycle, average EMF is again equals to 0. Therefore, this is called AC current and this is called AC voltage.